ABC is back, baby, and that's because the brand new card Revolution Synchron absolutely breaks this deck. What is going on, YouTube? It's your boy Spanko, and today I'm excited because with the release of Duelist Nexus, I think it's sometime next week, you guys are going to see that ABC is going to be one of the top performing decks in this format. Now, you guys might be wondering, ABC, that's a deck from 2016. Why would it be top performing right now? And that's because the addition of Revolution Synchron gives this deck so many new combos and access to some of the most broken cards in the extra deck. Now, before we get into the deck profile, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel for more Yu-Gi-Oh content just like this one. We upload 5 days a week here on the channel. We do deck profiles, combo videos, duel replays, and speaking of combo videos, in tomorrow's video, I'm going to be showing you guys some ABC combos that you need to know. So if you guys want to see that, make sure you guys are subscribed to tune in. Now, I don't want to keep this intro way too long. I really want to get into the deck profile. So with that, let's get right into it. So just before we get into the profile here, I do want to say I'm super excited that I'm going to be able to put ABC back on the map with the support of the Revolution Synchron, brand new card coming out in Dune, which is an absolutely insane card for this deck, and it gives such a big buff to this deck. Now, the really cool thing about it is that there's different ways to play this deck and different lines you can take, and I'm going to be talking about that. Of course, there are cards here in the side deck that I'll talk about as well, but this is the list that I'm kind of going with. I think it's the most consistent list, and it's a very, very powerful list. So let's get right into it. We are, of course, starting with 2 A Assault Core, 3 B Buster Drake, and 2 C Crush Wyvern. These are the best ratios for you, and the reason for that is because B is typically your best one. This is the only one you really want to draw, but your pieces in hand actually are not that great for you. So for that reason, I do like playing the 3 B and then the 2 of the other ones. You don't really want to draw them as much as you think, unless you're drawing them in combination with a Union Hanger. But again, these are your kind of quote unquote bricks in your deck, and there's a lot of combos you can do without these cards in your hand, so that's why you want to minimize them, but you just want to maximize on B, which is the best one. And then we're playing 2 Union Driver. I am a big believer that you have to play 2. It is one of those cards where yes, you can cut it to 1, you just hope you don't draw it. But the reason I like playing 2 is, first of all, if you do draw 1, then at least you could still combo with your Union Hanger. But this card in hand is actually not always the worst thing in the world, because you can still summon it off of your Sea Crush Wyvern. It's always pitch fodder for your ABC if you need it to be. So I really like this card. I still think this card being at 2 is the most optimal, just because again, if you draw it, you don't want to have to draw certain other cards to be able to combo. Okay, for example, let's say you're only playing 1. I just want to talk about this right now because I know this is kind of like a debate in the ABC community. If you're only playing 1 driver and you draw it, you would need to hope that you draw unauthorized reactivation with it, or now your combos become 3 or 4 card combos, which, by the way, there's a really cool 3 card combo where if you do open it but you have to have Revolution Sync card in your hand, you can kind of play through it. But again, it makes it really ugly where these 2 card combos now become 3 card combos that are very specific cards that you need to have. So that's why I like playing the 2 Union Driver. Of course, we're playing the 1 Terraforming and 3 Union Hanger, one of the most important cards in the deck to see. So 3 Union Hanger, as well as 3 Unauthorized Reactivation. I actually choose to max out on this because if for any reason you actually can't get to your Union Hanger, this card is essentially another Union Hanger for you, because if you're opening a piece plus this, you can still combo, which is really, really important. So that's why I really like 3 Unauthorized Reactivation. Also really helps where even if you have the full combo, you can always set this card, and then on your opponent's turn, you can activate it to target, let's say, your Dragon Buster, and then if they're trying to get rid of it with a spell card, you can equip B. Now it's unaffected by spells, A, unaffected by monsters, C, unaffected by traps. So Unauthorized Reactivation is really, really powerful in that sense. And then we're playing the 2 Regulus as well as the 2 Discolosseum. I like 2 and 2. I think this is all you're going to need. The reason for that is a lot of the time, if you're going into Ancient Fairy Dragon with your Union Hanger, you're always going to be able to get to the Discolosseum, which means you're always going to be able to get to the Regulus, of course, right? And I like playing 2 and 2 as well, because if you do draw this card, it's still a really good card to draw. It's still another combo extender for you. So that's why I like playing the 2 Regulus, the 2 Discolosseum. I think these are the perfect ratios for these cards. Now, I think typically this is a standard ABC lineup. This is not anything that I think should be changed, other than, I guess, 1 Union Driver or 2. Again, I'm a 2 guy, but it doesn't really make that much of a difference. So this is pretty much it for the ABC standard stuff. But now we're getting into this brand new card, Revolution Synchron, which is an absolutely insane card for this deck. It gives you so many new lines, and it's just so powerful. And keep in mind, this is really important. The effect doesn't actually activate in hand to synchro summon. So that's really important, because you're not activating the Revolution Synchron in hand to synchro summon into your Ancient Fairy Dragon. It's just going to be used as a material from your hand, all right? Really important to take note of. But this card is really, really powerful. So of course, we're playing 3. And in tomorrow's combos, I'm going to be showing you guys all the combos that you need to know with this card, because this card with ABC is absolutely insane. But to maximize on the consistency, we're also playing 2 Tuning. Now, why are we not playing 3? I think it's because this card, of course, one is not once per turn, but having multiple Revolution Synchrons in your hand doesn't really do anything for you. And typically, if you think about any other ratios of cards, you want to be playing 5 5 to 6 optimally, because this means that you're always going to see, or you have the highest odds, I should say, of seeing at least one in hand. Now, the problem is when you're playing 6, for example, of this, right? So you're playing 3 revolution plus 3 tuning. If you open multiple tunings, you're just getting too many cards in your hand that don't do anything. So I think 5 is the most optimal ratio. Plus, you're always going to be able to get to this card with cards like Prosperity again, which is your consistency, right? So if you don't have your tuning, you don't have your revolution, or let's say you have your revolution, you don't have your Union Hanger, Prosperity we're playing 3 of, because that's essentially going to be more of our consistency. So you can see the really cool thing about this deck is everything is going to get into each other, right? Everything is going to essentially get you to where you need to be to combo, and that's why I'm playing the 5 cards here. So these are like 5 names pretty much of a revolution, 3 power to Prosperity, which pretty much is going to replace most names in the new deck, which is really, really powerful. And that's it for our consistency stuff. I played a lot of hand traps now and a lot of board breaker kind of cards, because I think it's really important in this format to be able to go second and still be able to play, right? So for that reason, I'm playing 2 TTT. I think TTT is really important. It's also really good if your opponent goes Ash on your Union Hanger. The thing is with Union Hanger, which is really nice, if you open Union Hanger plus a piece, it doesn't really matter if they Ash your Union Hanger. You can still combo, which is absolutely insane. So that's why I really like the TTT, because your opponent a lot of the time won't know exactly where to hit this deck. And if they Ash incorrectly, or they Veiler, or they do something incorrectly, then TTT, you get so much use out of it. So I like playing the 2 triple tactics talent. Then I like playing 3 Ash, 3 Imperm, and 3 Droplet. These are kind of my hand trap slash board breakers of choice. I'm going to be talking about Droplet a bit more. I think Imperm and Ash are pretty self-explanatory. Very standard, very powerful going first for Imperm, but going second as well. It's a board breaker. But Forbidden Droplet, I really like. So when you are forced to go second, keep in mind all of the pieces, if they're on your side of the field, will get effects when they're sent to the graveyard. So if you have pieces on your side of the field and your opponent is trying to destroy them or get rid of them by any means, just so that essentially they can stop your combos, well, you can then chain Droplet, get those pieces off your field, negate your opponent's monsters, and then what you're going to be able to do is get the pieces effects off. So I think Droplet is really good in that sense going second, but going first, you can always set the Droplet after you finish your full combo, because when your ABC Buster Dragon tags out and summons the pieces back, now you have the pieces as fodder for your Droplet, which means you're going to use the Droplet to essentially negate cards your opponent controls, but you're also going to get all the effects of the pieces. So let's say you send a B and an A to negate 2, now you're going to get B effect, you're going to get A effect, and you're just going to keep steamrolling that advantage. So that's why I really like Droplet in this deck specifically. A card that I kind of also consider was Dark Ruler No More when you're forced to go second, but I think Droplet just makes so much sense in this deck. And then lastly, we're just playing the 1 Called by the Grave. Of course, this card, just to stop any hand traps, it's a very powerful card, right? So this is it for the main deck. It's 40 cards in the main deck. Moving on to the extra deck now, we are playing 3 ABC Dragon Buster. I like to play 3 personally. Typically, I play 3 just because I usually get rid of 1 off of Prosperity. So that's why I like to play the 3. I don't like playing 2 because it makes it so that if I get rid of a second 1 off of Prosperity, I only have 1 left, and then I'm playing against Kashtar or something and it gets ripped out of my extra deck, that becomes an issue, right? So that's why I'm playing the 3 ABC Dragon Buster, 1 Ancient Fairy Dragon, of course, and 1 Crystal Wing. I really like these because this is essentially a way that you're going to be playing around Nibiru and you're not going to lose to Nibiru, which is really, really important. And the last synchro I'm playing is the Baron DeFleur. Baron is really, really powerful as well, because keep in mind Revolution Synchron is level 3. Let's say you have your Ancient Fairy Dragon on your side of the field, and then you're able to special summon a Revolution Synchron, let's say with your Ancient Fairy effect. Essentially, then you can make a Baron, which is a level 10, which is really, really powerful, right? That's why I like playing the Baron. But another card that you can play instead of the Baron, which I thought was kind of spicy, was Black Rose Dragon. Now, Black Rose Dragon, when you are forced to go second, instead of making Ancient Fairy Dragon, you can make Black Rose and use this as a board breaker as well, which if your opponent has a negate, they have to negate this, right? This is kind of something that's really up to you. I know Baron's a little bit more pricey, so if you guys don't have access to a Baron, you guys can always play Black Rose Dragon here as well, and it becomes really, really powerful as well. I just wanted to give you guys that option. And then we're playing some generic Link monsters that I think are really good in this deck. So Platinum Gadget is really good for a lot of your combos. IP Masquerina is very, very much important. Like, this is one of the best cards that you can make in this deck. And then we're playing Lina because we're playing so many light pieces. So I thought Lina was just a good generic Link too that we can make into a lot of decks, and especially in the mirror match, it could be pretty cool as well. And then we're playing the 1 Nightmare Unicorn, 1 Apple, 1 Access Code, and 1 Underworld Goddess. Again, all cards that you're going to be making essentially off of your IP. Access Code is really easy to make on this deck as well. When you tag out with your Dragon Buster, you have a bunch of pieces on your side of the field, you make Access Code, you try to go for game. And then lastly, we're playing the 1 Tornado Dragon and 1 Baguska. I think these are just your generic toolbox card. Baguska is of course always going to be really good. Tornado Dragon, because we don't play any main deck back row hate, I think this card is pretty good in the main deck against back row decks, right? So that's it for the extra deck here.
15 cards. And the thing that I really love about ABC is most of your extra deck can just be toolbox, right? Outside of a few important key pieces, I think like IP, Platinum, your Buster, of course, and now with Revolution Synchron, your Fairy, as well as your Crystal Wing, these are the most important cards, and then it's just toolbox, which is really, really nice. And you can always adjust this depending on where the format goes. So if the format goes to a more back row heavy stuff, then you can adjust your extra deck to deal with that more. So this is a really cool thing I like about this deck. Now, I do want to talk about something just before we end off the video. I'm not showing you guys a side deck here. I already talked about Black Rose. Black Rose is another cool option for you. But there is lines where you can essentially go into your Hot Red Dragon Archfiend Abyss. And this is a pretty cool line that you guys can do with Samsara Dragon. It makes it really easy because essentially you can... I'll show you guys a combo tomorrow. You guys will see this combo tomorrow. But essentially with this line over here, you can pretty much end on like an IP, an ABC, a Therion, plus a Hot Red Dragon Archfiend Abyss. However, the only thing with this combo is it loses a little bit harder to cards like Nibiru, loses a little bit more to hand traps. And although this can be kind of good against Dark Ruler, specifically if you have a back row already set on your field, because you can chain your back row, then you can go Hot Red, target the Dark Ruler, and they can stop the Dark Ruler. I just think there's too many flaws in this combo. There's too many fragile points where you can lose with this combo, which is why I'm not playing these cards. Although they are really, really powerful and you can definitely play them, I just really like going the safer route, fitting in more hand traps and board breakers, so that no matter what the situation you're in, you're going to be able to kind of out that situation, right? Whereas Torque 2 gear doesn't do anything for you if you draw it, doesn't do anything for you if you're not going into this line. Like if you're not going into this combo line, and let's say you have a combo, right, and you're not going into this line, then this doesn't really do anything for you. That's why I'm not a huge fan of playing this line, although I will still show you guys a combo in tomorrow's video. And then lastly, Skill Drain is really, really powerful. I think Skill Drain is the other card that I was debating as well in the main deck rather than Droplet, because if you're going first, you can still end on Skill Drain, which is really, really powerful. Now you guys might be wondering, why would you play Skill Drain in a main deck where you're playing a bunch of cards that want a combo? The thing is with Skill Drain that's really, really powerful is most of these things, like your pieces are all going to activate in the graveyard, so Skill Drain is not going to affect them. On top of that, your pieces, when they're in the spell and trap card zone, are not monsters, so you can still use them to summon them even through Skill Drain. And then ABC Dragon Buster tags itself out first because you can still activate the effect under your Skill Drain, so you tag out and then it's going to resolve in the graveyard, which means that you can still banish a card, you can still tag into all the new pieces, which is really, really powerful, right? So that's why Skill Drain is really, really good and just synergizes with this deck. Oh, on top of that, it works with Regulus, because Regulus is the same thing. It's going to get itself off the field before the effect resolves. So essentially with Regulus, with Dragon Buster, with all your pieces, they all work under Skill Drain. So I was just thinking Skill Drain is another really cool option for you in the main deck. However, when you guys are building your side deck, I feel like this for sure should go on the side deck if you're not main decking it. I was just thinking like, hey, instead of Droplet, maybe play 3 Skill Drain. I just wanted to give you guys that option, just give you guys that knowledge as well. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I think ABC is very sleeper in today's format. I think it's going to do a lot of different things and people are not going to see it coming. So I really think you guys should try this deck out, especially with the addition of Revolution Synchron. This deck is competitive and this deck is really, really fun. So that is it for today's video. I hope you guys did enjoy. That was my take on ABC for the post-Duelist Nexus format. I think this deck is insane. I think it has so many cool combos. There's so many different combos that you guys can do that maybe in the exact list that I showed you guys can't do. But speaking of combos, in tomorrow's video, I'm going to be showing you guys combos that my deck list can play, the Abyss combos, all different things that you guys can do, and show you guys why this deck is so powerful. Now, if you guys want to see that, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel for more Yu-Gi-Oh! Content. We upload 5 days a week here on the channel, deck profiles, combo videos, duel replays, all that good stuff. And you guys are going to get 5 shorts a week, which means you guys are going to get a little bit of everything and you guys are always going to have something to watch. Make sure you guys subscribe for all of that. Thank you guys all for watching. I appreciate every single one of you. And with that, Spanko signing out. Peace.